Paul Manafort surrendered to federal authorities Monday morning, after a person close to the case said the first charges were filed in a special counsel investigation. The charges against Mr. Manafort, President Trump's former campaign chairman, were not immediately clear but represent a significant escalation in a special counsel investigation that has cast a shadow over the president's first year in office. Also charged was Mr. Manafort's former business associate Rick Gates, who was also told to surrender on Monday, the person said. Mr. Manafort walked into the F.B.I.'s field office in Washington at about 8:15 a.m. with his lawyer. Mr. Gates is a longtime protégé and junior partner of Mr. Manafort. His name appears on documents linked to companies that Mr. Manafort's firm set up in Cyprus to receive payments from politicians and businesspeople in Eastern Europe, records reviewed by the New York Times show. Mr. Manafort had been under investigation for violations of federal tax law, money laundering, and whether he appropriately disclosed his foreign lobbying. Continue reading the main story. Related coverage. Hopes dim for congressional Russia inquiries as parties clash October 22, 2017. How the Russia investigation entangled a Manafort protégé June 16, 2017. Paul Manafort expects to be indicted, longtime Trump advisor says September 26, 2017. With a picked lock and a threatened indictment, Mueller's inquiry sets a tone September 18, 2017. Recent comments. MC 3 minutes ago. Still a long road ahead of us. Should be Michael Flynn next. Then Donald Trump Jr., Jared Kushner. Then Donald Trump. We should always start. NSL 4 minutes ago. House of Cards, watch them fall. Every penny spent for Mueller is worth holding the rich and powerful accountable. Chris 4 minutes ago. An indictment full of sound and fury, signifying nothing. See all comments. Write a comment. Attempts to reach Mr. Gates on Monday were not successful. A spokesman for Mr. Manafort did not immediately respond to a request for comment. Mr. Manafort has expected charges since this summer, when FBI agents raided his home and prosecutors warned him that they planned to indict him. That warning raised speculation that Mr. Manafort might try to cut a deal to avoid prosecution. Mr. Trump's lawyer, Ty Cobb, said there were no concerns that Mr. Manafort would offer damaging information about the president in exchange for a deal. Some close to Mr. Manafort, including his former business partner Roger J. Stone Jr., have said he had nothing to offer that would help prosecutors build a case against Mr. Trump. He's not going to lie, Mr. Stone said in September. Mr. Manafort, a veteran Republican strategist, joined the Trump campaign in March 2016 to help keep delegates from breaking with Mr. Trump in favor of establishment Republican candidates. Mr. Trump soon promoted him to chairman and chief strategist, a job that gave him control over day-to-day operations of the campaign. But Mr. Trump fired Mr. Manafort just months later, after reports that he received more than $12 million in undisclosed payments from Viktor F. Yanukovych, the former Ukrainian president and a pro-Russia politician. Mr. Manafort spent years as a political consultant for Mr. Yanukovych. American intelligence agencies have concluded that President Vladimir V. Putin of Russia launched a stealth campaign of hacking and propaganda to try to damage Hillary Clinton and help Mr. Trump win the election. The Justice Department appointed Robert S. Mueller III as special counsel in May to lead the investigation into the Russian operations and to determine whether anyone around Mr. Trump was involved, Mr. Trump has denied any such collusion, and no evidence has surfaced publicly to contradict him. At the same time, Mr. Trump and his advisors this year repeatedly denied any contacts with Russians during the campaign, only to have journalists uncover one undisclosed meeting after another. The New York Times revealed in July that Mr. Manafort and others close to Mr. Trump met with Russians last year, on the promise of receiving damaging political information about Mrs. Clinton. Now News.